Long, and welcome to another episode of GMS on Ustream, streaming live. My name is Elder Gabor.
Elder Ramlab.
Elder Rakar.
And basically, it's an open forum. We have Elder Manadzak here, Elder Tahar, as well as Elder Ayatan. And basically, it's an open forum to discuss our favorite topic, which is America. America being destroyed. America's destruction.
America's down.
And basically, the so-called white man, his kingdom, the Most High has an appointed day and an appointed time to take this devil out. Just like when you read about the Babylonian Empire, it was an appointed day and appointed time for them to go out. Well, it's the same thing with America, right? And we're going to begin. Bring it up.
This is the book of Psalms, the 49th chapter, in the 11th verse. Their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever and their dwelling places to all generations.
Right, that's talking about the elites of this society. They think they're going to rule forever. In particular, the Rothschilds, the Rockefellers, you know, and those lesser banking families. Now, they're the ones that rule this cesspool called America as well as the rest of the world. So they believe they're going to rule forever. That's what that scripture is talking about. Read it again.
It says, their inward thought is that their houses shall continue forever and their dwelling places to all generations.
Right. These devils think that they're going to rule forever, basically. And the point is that they're not. They're going to go down. All right? Go on.
They call their lands after their own names.
That right there lets you know it's talking about the so-called white man. The name America, where did it come from? The so-called white man, Amerigo Vespucci. The name Africa came from the so-called white man, Leo Scipio Africanus. All right? So that scripture right there lets you know that it's talking about the so-called white man. All right? But it's not going to say the white man calls the lands after his own names.
Right.
You know, the Bible is written in something called dark sayings.
Right.
When you look up the word dark sayings, it's a saying that's wrapped in mystery. Like a riddle. And you got to know how to break down the riddle for you to understand it, what the saying is saying. Dark sayings, parables.
Right. Parables, yeah.
That's in the book of, matter of fact, let's go there real quick. Psalm 78.
Okay.
That's what the Bible is written in. That's why the Bible is not given to everybody. It's only given to the prophets. And that's who we are. We're the prophets, man. And the word prophet means to say before. That's all it means. The Heavenly Father has given us His special spirit to understand these scriptures and to say things that are going to happen before it happens. That's it.
Right.
You hear the word prophet, you're thinking of a Yoda-type mystical being floating.
In a lotus position.
Yeah, in a lotus position, floating left and right, side to side, front and back.
Some magical guru,
you know, when he appears, you hear music and the harps and shit.
Yeah,
you know,
and that's why that when that dude, Dr. York, was out there supposedly in New York teaching, that, and he said that Michael the Archangel was gonna teach class on certain days of the week. You niggas ate that shit up like cotton candy.
Well, like we said about you niggas, you all, we're talking about you two-thirds niggas. You're always looking for a show, you know, for frills and cheap frills. And that's why you love Nate Snakin so much, you know, with his bullshit. That's why he put that video together.
Yep.
That, bah, bah, that Ghostbusters type music, you know, because that's what you niggas love. Go on.
Psalms chapter 78, verse 1. Give ear, O my people, to my law. Incline your ears to the words of my mouth. I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter dark sayings of old.
And that's found right here in the Bible. That's the Lord saying how He would bring out His word. He would bring out His word. Read the second verse.
I will open my mouth in a parable.
The Lord's mouth is this word. All right, really, we're His mouth, but we're speaking what? His words. A true prophet of the Lord would come and speak what? The Lord's word. What did Yahweh Shai come and speak? He come and speak His own word?
No. Nope.
No, He came to speak the Lord's word. All right, stay in there and then you're going to go to that. Go on.
It says, I will open my mouth in a parable. I will utter dark sayings of old.
Now, the Lord's word is written in a parable. and a dark saying. Now all you brothers got to do is look up the word parable and look up the word dark saying. Then you understand that this Bible is written in a mystery, all right? All right, where you going?
John.
Okay, go on.
John chapter 5, verse 30. I can of mine own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge.
Yeah, this is the words of Yahweh Shai. This is Yahweh Shai speaking. Go on.
I can of mine own self do nothing. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just.
Right, lines up to us too. All right? This is not our own judgment, our own words. This is the judgment of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, whom the world is getting ready to know. All right? Because as it stands now, you know him as the Lord, Jesus Christ. You know all these titles. You don't know his name. The Lord is going to use us to publish his name.
That's right.
And you got these other guys that's talking about the name of the Lord is not important. You know how great the Lord is going to make his name?
Yep.
Part of the destruction of America is to uplift what?
The name of the Lord.
Yep. The name of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. I guarantee you, after the destruction happens, you're going to know that name, Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai.
Right.
All right? Go on.
Because I seek not mine own will, but the will of the Father which hath sent me.
Right, that's what Yahweh Shai said. And we have the same sentiment. All right? We seek his will. And part of his will is to have this place destroyed, be destroyed, leveled, flattened. And the Lord is going to glorify himself in America's destruction. America's through, man. Just before we started filming, you know, watching the TV, and pretty much they're rehashing all the songs of the 70s in commercials, and they're running out of ideas. Yeah. Why? Because America's going down. That's all these subtle little signs of this place going down. You want to say something, brother?
Yeah. Like Michael Jackson said, this is it.
This is it.
Like they had a song back in the days, man. This is it. Man, yeah, yeah. This thing's who you are. I know we made up
McDonald's,
stuff like
right.
that.
Right.
No,
right.
Somebody else.
Okay.
No, yeah, Michael McDonald's, Kenny Loggins.
Kenny Loggins. This is it. Make no mistakes, we are. Don't make no mistakes.
He was singing it too.
America's gone, man. It's done. Okay, you fucking white people, man.
That's why, hey, if I may say this. Yeah, that's why Oprah made her big decision or big announcement, a big emotional announcement that next year is going to be her last year broadcasting.
Yeah.
Why? Because and then she said, something in my bones.
Yeah.
I feel it in my spirit. You know, she knows something, man. She knows that this place is over. Right?
Yeah, she knows she's over.
She knows, she knows she's over. Right. And basically, those that are in the know that are higher up than her have told her that something's about to go down.
Yep.
That's what he told her by 2011. You better get the hell up out of here. But you know what? The Most High works. Hey, they say it in the church all the time. The Most High works in mysterious ways. The Most High can take this place out this year, 2010. I mean, we're in 2009 now, but the Most High can take this place out in 2010.
Yeah, it very well could be the year. All right, bring on what you got.
Job chapter 14, verse 5.
Yeah,
seeing his days are determined.
Right, his day, and if you notice, speaking about days, the Lord is speeding up these days.
Yeah.
Hey, like right now we're doing the show, it'll seem like in less than a day that we're going to be here next week doing the show.
And I'm always telling y'all.
Yeah, the Elder Tar always says that. These days are being, I've never seen days like this being sped up like this, man.
Last week we were doing the show and it seemed like we were just here. Like this is the second installment of the same day, you know, basically.
15 minutes ago,
we took a break, like we never left here. We took a break, ate some food, then came back, and now we're doing the next installment.
Yeah, that's true. Now, in our kingdom, our days are going to be long. You know that old saying, the dog days of summer?
Yeah.
That's how our kingdom is going to be. It's going to be long. We're going to enjoy those days. Like even in your kingdom, so-called white man, you can't even enjoy the day. The day goes by so quick.
Yeah.
Hey, this guy we work with, he's always saying that. The day is going by so quick. It's going by so quick. You know why? Because the Lord is speeding up those days for that appointed day for your destruction.
Right.
See, there's an appointed day and an appointed time and an appointed hour where this place is just going to be wiped out of here. It's
going
to be a dream. a nightmare that finally ends.
Yep.
Right? Yeah.
I'm gonna go back.
Okay, go on.
Job chapter 14, verse 5. Seeing his days are determined.
Go on.
The number of his months are with thee.
Right, the number of his months are with thee. Like we gave an example of the Babylonian Empire. All right, Belshazzar was told that handwriting on the wall,
yep.
You know, mighty, mighty, Tikal, Upharsin, your days you have been weighed,
you have been found wanting.
Your days, basically, your days are numbered.
That's it.
And I believe that very night,
Belshazzar
was taken out.
Yep, yep.
And Darius came in
the Medo-Persian Empire.
Right, the Medo-Persian Empire was ushered in. Yep. So the Heavenly Father don't play, man. Is that, what make you think it's going to be any different with America? Yeah, pass it to everything.
Yeah, that writing on the wall, that's where you get that saying, the writing is on the wall.
Mm-hmm.
Well, anyway, that language wasn't in Hebrew, so-called Aramaic. It wasn't even in the language of the Chaldean language. It was in the mystery language. Mm-hmm. And it was Daniel, I believe, that broke it down.
Right, that's right.
All right? So when you talk about speaking in tongues or unknown language, that was really one of the only times that you heard of the example of an unknown language. Because when you go to, was that 1 Corinthians, the 14th chapter? Tells you about speaking in tongues. It's talking about other languages, man. But have somebody stand in and interpret. Because Paul spoke Greek and Hebrew.
That's right.
All right? And then the apostles in Acts, was that Acts the second chapter? They spoke in tongues, meaning they spoke in different languages of the Israelites that came from the different parts of the planet Earth speaking the language that they were born in.